evening to Madam Lim Chai Peng and all my fellow friends. My name is Nur Azli Binti Iskan and my metric number is 184025. Okay, as a second presenter, I would like to remind all of you that our title of presentation today is Two Major Ways to Provide Healthcare. So, Salvani already explained about the first point, which is education, and I will explain the second point, which is how to maintain our personal hygiene, and I will do the conclusion. Okay, in order to maintain our personal hygiene, there are two ways, which is through clean food and clean water. How to make sure that the food that we eat is clean? It is by choosing good quality of raw material. For example, when we go to the supermarket, we only have to buy the fresh raw material, for example, fresh vegetable and fresh meat. And we have to avoid from buying the rotten one, because the rotten vegetable or meat may contain many bacteria that can be harmful to our body system. Other than that, it is better if we plant our vegetable by ourselves near our house, so that we can make sure the vegetable does not contain any chemical substances. Next, we have to apply the good behavior during food preparation. Next. Okay, as we can see at this slide, we have to wash our hands, we have to wash our raw material to make sure there is no spreading of the bacteria to the food. And we also have to wipe our cooking area, and it is to avoid from cross-contamination between us and the food. Other than that, if we feel any flu, so we do not sneezing or coughing to the food, because the bacteria from our body may transfer to the food. Then we also have to cook our food at the right temperature, which is above 100 degrees Celsius. So in order to maintain our personal hygiene, we also have to drink and use clean water for our personal activity, for example, brushing our teeth, bathing and washing our clothes. Okay, how to make sure the water is clean and safe to use? We have to boil the water before drink, because as we know nowadays, the water is very dirty, and it's better if we filter the water before we boil at 100 degrees Celsius. Other than that, we also have to avoid from using stagnant water, because stagnant water may contain many contaminants, for example, bacteria and virus. And if we use this stagnant water for our personal hygiene, it will lead to many diseases, for example, malaria. So, in short, in order to maintain our personal hygiene, there are two ways to maintain the personal hygiene, which is through clean food and clean water. Okay, now is the time for me to conclude this presentation. In conclusion, healthcare is important in our daily life, and education and personal hygiene is two big things in order to provide healthcare. We have to educate the community since they are young, so that they are exposed to how to improve our healthcare. And we have everybody should apply the